In this video, we will study about certain properties of solid, liquids and gases. So first property that we are going to study is shape and volume. A solid has a fixed shape and a fixed volume. Solid has a fixed shape and fixed volume. It is generally hard. So solids are generally hard. This is because the molecules are so tightly held that they cannot move closer to or away from their position. So solids are hard because why they are hard? Because their molecules are tightly packed. You can see in the diagram that one of the solid it is they have shown. So already we are knowing that solids are hard. Why they are hard? Because their molecules are tightly packed. Whereas a liquid has a fixed volume but no fixed shape. Liquid has fixed volume but no fixed shape. It takes the shape of container. The molecules in a liquid are not so tightly held as in solid. So molecules in liquids are not so tightly held, so they can move or slip over one another. Such movement, however, stops at the surface of container, and so the liquids take the shape as the container. The volume of a liquid is fixed as the intermolecular space remains unchanged when the liquid changes shape. For example, if we pour any volume, you can say take 200 milliliter of a liquid from one container to another, the shape of liquid will change but not its volume. Its volume, that is 200 milliliter, would remain same. So the only the shape will change but the volume of liquid will remain same. A gas, you can see in the diagram also that each time only the shape is changing but the volume is same. A gas has neither a fixed volume nor a fixed shape, but in case of gases they have neither a fixed shape nor fixed volume. It assumes the volume and shape of the container. In a gas, the intermolecular force is so weak. Intermolecular force, that we have already studied. What is intermolecular force? The force of attraction between the molecules of gas, it will be called as intermolecular force, is so weak that molecules are free to move to every part of the container and occupy its entire volume. Thus, a gas assumes the volume and shape of the container. So, the gases do not have fixed shape nor fixed volume. Next property is compressibility. A solid is practically non-compressible, means we cannot press it or compress it. A liquid is compressible to a little extent. The liquids can be compressed to a little extent, but a gas is compressible to a very great extent. This is because the intermolecular space is very small in solid, larger in liquid, and largest in gases. So, compressibility depends upon space or intermolecular space. More the intermolecular space, more the compressibility would be there. So in case of gases, space is more or intermolecular space is more, so they can be compressed more as compared to solids and liquids. As the intermolecular space increases, the molecules can be pushed together more easily. Next property is fluidity. Solids do not flow, but liquids and gases do. So solids do not flow,
whereas liquids and gases can flow. Why they can? Because cohesion is very strong, or intermolecular force is very strong in case of solids, but not in liquids and gases. For this property, liquids and gases are called fluids. It is natural tendency of gases to flow from higher zone to lower pressure zone. We should know that it's their natural tendency that they flow from higher pressure zone to lower pressure zone. The intermolecular force is large in higher pressure zone than in lower pressure zone, and so they flows. Next property that we are going to study is thermal expansion. What is meant by thermal expansion? Thermal expansion means expansion on being heated. What is meant by thermal expansion? Thermal expansion means expansion on being heated. The thermal expansion of solid is very small. In case of solid, expansion is very small. That of liquid is larger and that of gases is the largest. So maximum expansion can be seen in gases and least in case of solid. On being heated, the molecules absorb energy and move apart. The smaller the intermolecular force, further molecules will move, and larger is the expansion. This results in the above mentioned effect. So we can get idea from the by performing the following activity. So by performing activity also, we can see how thermal expansion is there. So what we have to do? We have to take two wooden blocks of same height in front of a wall, or we have to place two wooden blocks of same height in front of a wall. Place a metal rod on the blocks in such a way that one end of it is fixed to the wall. Attach a paper pointer to a round pencil. Place the pencil below the free end of the rod. Now what we have to do? Heat the rod. The rod expands and the pencil rotates, and so does the pointer. So you can see in the diagram also. So this activity proves the thermal expansion in case of solids.